Okay, so you got power button, reset button, two USB, three ports, headphone, microphone jack, three 5 1/4 drives and a hole for a fan. And tech logo on the box. You can see the side panel actually bevels out, not in, but we'll talk about that later. Let's move round to the back now. This is the IO shield, fan mount, 7 PCI slots, 2 water cooling holes, and the PSU mount. Moving around to the other side, you can see it's the same style apart from it's got a 120mm fan mount. Up top we've got another 120mm fan included. Let's take the panel off and have a closer look inside. It's held on with 2 thumb screws. I'll just move the case a bit closer. We'll take a look at the contents later on in the video. This is the hard drive bay. 3 2-inch 5 1/4 bays. A rear 120mm fan included. 4 rubber pads for the power supply. Ventilation, 120 or 140mm fan mount. Cable management tool. A large CPU cutout for easy access. Let's take a look at the internal connectors. You've got your power header. You've got a reset header. You've got your hard drive header. You've got your power indicator. Front panel audio. And your USB 3.0 header. Moving on to the bottom. We've got a removable dust filter for the power supply as the fan will face down when mounted. We've got 4 holes for SSD mounting, 4 rubber feet, the filter fits back in with ease. I'm just going to take the front panel off. This is a cable management hole for the front panel, 120mm fan mount, 3 5 1/4 bays. The first 3 panels are removable. The removable panels have just filters, but the rest of the panel doesn't. They are held into place by push clips. I will show you how they come out. They are pushed back in with ease. I've routed the cables through the hole I mentioned. The whole front panel clips back into place. I'll remove the side panel so we can take a closer look. This is where the power supply cables have come through. They can be routed through here and here. There is very little room to hide cables here. As mentioned earlier, the beveled side panel allows extra room for cables. These are the tool-less mount system for the hard drives. The hard drive slides in with ease and you'll hear a slight click when it's in place. There is a mount for an SSD at the top here. These are the 4 holes I showed you earlier that you can mount an SSD onto. Let's take a look at the contents included. There are two list brackets for mountain. We also have a mixed pack of screws including standoffs for motherboard installation. There is also a quick product overview included. That concludes the video. Thank you for watching.